Hi, I'm Stephanie from the Air Navigation team, and on today's video I will introduce to you the new and improved bar. Let's have a look at it. The first thing you will notice is that we added some transparency on the navigation bar, so you can actually see the map below. This is especially convenient for mobile devices. Another visual improvement is that we made the font size of the values bigger to make them easier to read even while flying. But the best news is that now the bar can be customized to your own needs. You can now choose what information you want to be displayed. To do this, long press on the field you wish to modify and it will open a list of options. Unfortunately, on this menu, Martini is not an option. You can scroll down to see more options, decide which value you would like, and then simply select it by tabbing on it. Furthermore, our bar is even intelligent and will not show you the same information twice. So let's say I change the field where I have the ground speed information, and I select as new value altitude that is already being displayed right next to it on the bar. Instead of showing me altitude twice, as you can see, ground speed is now displayed where previously altitude was. Basically, they swapped places. Additionally to being able to customize the bar, the following items have actions when you tap on them. Next waypoint, altitude, current position. You can identify them by the yellow symbol on the side. The first one is the next waypoint. Simply tap on it to open the list of waypoints of your route. You can choose your next leg by selecting it. In my case, this would be Martini.
I lied. On this menu, Martini is an option.
The second field is the altitude. By tapping on it, you can open the menu to set the QNH manually or enable the automatic setup. The last one is the current position. By tapping on it, you can easily create a user waypoint on the spot. A pop-up will ask you if you want to open the editor. Choose cancel and it will create the waypoint at the current position with the default settings. Or tap on show to open the waypoint editor to be able to change some details, like setting a different elevation, changing the name, or choosing a specific tag for it. My last comment is about the new navigation bar on mobile devices. When no route is set, the bar will show a short version of only one row. Once you configured a route, it will change and display two rows with more information. On the top row, you can customize the fields, but only select values related to your route, like for example, estimate time of arrival or the next waypoint. The bottom row can only be customized by choosing values related to the GPS or the external sensors. For example, track speed, altitude, the coordinates, acceleration, vertical speed, etc.
And with that, we reached the end of the video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and enjoy the new bar. But remember, don't drink and fly, fly safe, fly with Air Navigation Pro. Cheers!